Fillout just came out with their new scheduler, allowing us to schedule inside of our Fillout forms against our own availability and calendars. But they didn't stop there. In this week, they are doing a launch week where they're pushing out a ton of new features, and my favorite one that just came out is the Round Robin Scheduler, making their scheduling capability even more robust. If you are ready to learn about how the Round Robin event can benefit you and your organization, stick around and let's get into it. Welcome back to the channel. If you're new here, my name is Gareth. This is Gap Consulting, and it's our mission to help you unlock the full potential of your no-code tools. One of my favorite no-code tools is Fillout, and this is exactly what we're going to be diving into here today. They are one of the, if not the best, form softwares out there, and their scheduler is now taking on the likes of Calendly and is completely affordable. So in this video, I'm going to be breaking down their newest feature on the scheduler, the Round Robin. But before we get to it, I first want to invite you to join me for automation training. If you're new to no-code, automation is the thing that's going to allow you to reclaim your time and is one of the most powerful features inside of no-code tools in general. That is exactly why I built my tool-agnostic training that's going to teach you the fundamentals of building in any no-code automation software. If you're interested, go ahead and grab that training for free at gapconsulting.io/webinar-registration. I'll include links wherever you found this video. But without further ado, let's hop on into the heart of things and actually get into the new Round Robin feature. Let's dive on into my screen here. This is what happens when you are signed into Fillout. Feel free to follow along. If you don't already have a Fillout account, you can sign up for free. And if you would sign up using our affiliate link, which I will include near this video, it's a great way for you to show some love back to the channel. Now, once you're inside of Fillout, in order to access Scheduler, you need to go up to the Scheduling tab. This is available on all of the different Fillout tiers. And here you're going to see the different people who are on your team. You can flip between the grid view and the column view here. So if you have more team members, you know, one of these view types might be preferable. And if you ever want to add new members to your team, we've covered this in previous videos, but you'll see it all right here. So when you're adding these people, they first need to integrate their calendar, and this icon is going to show you who is integrated and who is not. If they have not yet integrated their calendar to Fillout, then of course you're not going to be able to add them and their availability to a Round Robin event. So make sure that they are in fact successfully connected before we move on. Now, the first point I need to make is that when you're adding somebody here, you must have admin level user in order to create and view the Round Robin event. So back inside of our members here, we can take a look at team members to see who has what level of permission. So here, only certain people on our team have admin level. This means that they can edit, view all of the different forms, including the Round Robin. Now, those people on our team who just have the user capability are only able to integrate their calendar and create their own forms. They cannot actually edit or dismantle the Round Robin form links that you create. So in order to create a Round Robin event, we're going to go to schedule a new form, and we are now prompted to choose one of the three different types available. We will choose Round Robin. I also want to point out that after you create an event, if you want to upgrade it or change it to a Round Robin, you can do that later. So if you pick one type, you can always update it in the future. So here we are, we've got our first Round Robin coming together, and everyone who has their calendar integrated is showing up as a potential option for us to select from. So in this particular example, I'll choose Jared and I will choose Diana as viable options for this Round Robin event. You can add as many as you'd like here. And of course, as I mentioned, if you haven't already invited someone, you can then do that here as well. So now that I've selected my hosts, I'm going to go to the next screen, which is asking us for the meeting title and the event duration. This is very, very similar to the other schedulers that are out there. So you're probably familiar with how to create this already. Now that we have this, we will create the actual link and we can name the form. I'll keep it with the default of 30 minute, but I might add at the end here, RR for Round Robin. Let's now continue. And now, point number two that I want to highlight is that we have people's avatars showing up here. So the two people that we selected, in our case, Jared and Diana, are now showing up here on our Round Robin. And very likely when you're offering a Round Robin event, you won't want the individual profile avatars to show up. So we can update that. So let's click on customize here and we can change the picture. So we can go to custom here. We can drop in a custom image. So I can find, for example, a logo for Gap Consulting. I'll drop that in right here. And hopefully this is a proper size. That'll do. Once it uploads, we click done. And now that's being replaced here. So that particular icon is kind of getting smushed. You'll probably want to find something that's 100 pixels by 100 pixels or thereabouts. That way it shows up more accurately and doesn't get smushed. Now at this point, we need to have a quick discussion about how a round robin works. A traditional round robin event type will say, hey, whoever was last scheduled is going to get the next appointment, provided that they have availability. So for example, if something were booked here, again, we have two different users. We have Jared and Diana. If somebody were booking for, let's say, the 5th at 10 a.m., they would get either one, either Jared or Diana, if they both had availability. After that event is scheduled, when a subsequent event comes up, the next person who will be scheduled, assuming, of course, that they are available, will be the person who had the least recent scheduled event. So, for example, if Jared is scheduled and then someone goes to schedule another event, since Jared received the last booking, the next one will most likely go to Diana if she is available. If she is not available, it will go to Jared again. The next event that goes to be scheduled will go to Diana if she's available because she has not been scheduled yet. So this is how it works. The person who has had the least recent booking is going to get the next booking, assuming that they are available at the date and time selected. But Fillout takes it a step further. Inside of our participants, we can drill in and we see that we have the ability to set a priority for our different host pool. So if I want Jared to get more of the calls scheduled with him, perhaps he is a more senior consultant, for example, or maybe his schedule is more open and I want to build his book of business and temporarily give him a boost in new consultations. Well, I can come in here and set a priority. Whoever has a highest priority is going to get that event if more than one person is available at the same time. So if Jared and Diana are both available, and I've given Jared a priority of 5, and I've given Diana a priority of 4, if they're both available when someone goes to make a scheduled consultation, they will get Jared every time. His priority is higher. Only if all of the available hosts have the equal level of priority, then and only then will we consider who got scheduled least recently. So the round robin is really customizable. We get a lot of control over who is going to get more of these calls booked for them, depending on our priority. But we can ditch this for our needs here. Let's set everyone to the middle priority so that we have an equal priority for all of the various hosts available. Next, we have to consider where will these meetings be held? We can go over here to separate locations and actually set up different locations for each of the hosts, or we can establish the same location for everyone. So we could simply say, everyone's integrated their Google Calendar. We're going to have all of these in Google Meets, the end. But that's not necessarily what needs to happen. Maybe we want to set up a separate location and we say, hey, actually, Jared will take these calls in Google Meet. But if you're scheduling with Diana, maybe we need to get the invitee's phone number and we're going to give you a call. Or maybe it's a meeting that's happening in person or in Zoom or who knows what. So this level of control is really nice. You can set up a different location for each event host so that depending on who actually gets selected for the booking, the meeting is going to be held in a different place. So here we'll go ahead and set up the organizer's phone. Let's pretend we've got a phone number of 888-555-1212, and we are good now with our separate locations, Jared in Google Meet, Diana by phone. Let's go ahead and publish this form now, and from here we can give it a test. We can check out the form, open it up in a new URL, copy and paste that link, and now look to schedule. Now remember, because of the round robin, we first look at priority. So are both people available? Yes. If so, then we're going to look at their priority. If the priority is equal, then we will say who was last scheduled. So here, I might schedule for the 5th at 10 a.m. I'll put in my name and email, and then we can go ahead and schedule the event. And now back inside of Fillout, I simply go into my form results. I can refresh these results if I need to, and I can look here to see who I was scheduled with on this event, and there it is, scheduled with Diana. Now, if I were to schedule the same event date and time, let's flip back here and refresh our form. Again, this was the 5th at 10 a.m., and if I were to do it now, because Diana is no longer available, I'm going to get scheduled with Jared. So let's go ahead and test this out. Schedule the event. And just like that, we can flip back now into Fillout, refresh our results again. And now we're going to see by expanding this that the most recent form has scheduled with Jared. So this is how the round robin works. We're going to float through the different folks that are available hosts based on availability, priority, and then lastly, who needs a new call scheduled, who hasn't had one for the longest amount of time. So an amazing way to get everyone on your team participating with these events and also offering maximum availability to your prospective clients. Now, as a final point, I want to review the pricing for this because honestly, I think it's a little nuts. I love the guys at Fillout, but they are giving away so much value for free here. If you're not already using Fillout Scheduler, you have really no excuse. On side of this, we see that in the free account, we get unlimited seats, meaning that we can add as many different people to our account as we would like. And if we scroll on down here, we see that the Fillout Scheduling is available even on the free tier. So if you're paying for Calendly or some other booking service, you don't need to be spending that money anymore. Fillout is where it's at. Not only do you get more robust forms, but now their scheduler is coming after the likes of Calendly and Acuity Scheduling. I know we went pretty quickly in this video, so if there are any questions you have that we did not yet address, please drop them below. And in the meantime, keep on building.